What up, Life Pack? I took my hair down, guys. I took it down. I didn't wash it yet. Because me and Dre about to run to the grocery store. So I just took it down and threw a scarf on it. And yeah, so I'm waiting on Dre. She went to go cut some hair. What her other job does she do on the side when she ain't in the trucks? She's home cutting hair. She just got done cutting her, our boy's hair last night. And now she's cutting hair where she's at. So I'm waiting on her. We're about to go to the grocery store, get some food. She's talking about making some garlic parmesan wings. I don't even think I want chicken wings today. But I'm hungry, but I don't want chicken wings. You know, you always got that craving something, but it ain't, you know, what everybody naming off. So anyway, I keep looking up at the screen, guys. Maybe I should just close it. But anyway, yeah, so we'll be back when Dre get here. All right. Guess who came home finally? She's finally done and home.
What's going on, Life Pack? I'm taking care of business via text, so don't mind me, y'all.
So yeah, what you do? I told you you went to go cut some more hair.
Yeah, I did. I'm always busy. I can't never sit still. And she complains. I'm sorry, this is a hustle in me. I gotta get it. When people, now see, I have a few customers and I told them, well, I'll be gone like 2 or 3 weeks. You know, they actually wait.
To get their hair cut?
To get their hair cut by me. So that makes me feel kind of good because that lets me know they like my work that much. They don't want anybody else in their head. So the next guy I just cut, a friend of ours, and I told him, I said,
ain't no friend of ours. I don't even know the boy.
Our son's brother's friend. So he told me that, I told him, I said, well, I'm going to be gone for like 3 weeks. And when I get back, I'm going on vacation. Oh, man, what I'm going to do? I said, the best thing for you to do is catch me when I get back. And I'll be here for a day. And then we are out, leaving, going on a long vacation. Much needed, overdue.
It ain't long. We're going to be gone for a week.
That's long enough.
That's long without the kids, but that ain't exactly long. You got like we going for months.
Shit, if I could, I would.
Anyway, y'all. So we're about to get ready to go to the store and get some. I'm hungry now. Like, I've been waiting for her all day that I'm hungry. Like, really? So, I don't know what we're going to do, but we'll be back once we figure it out.
Shit, I'm already down, bro.
So we'll be back once we figure it out, guys.
All right. Peace out, Life Pack.
I hate these sunglasses, guys.
I don't know why them. What is your problem? I have very sensitive eyes. The sun is still out. So I have to wear shades to protect a little bit of vision that I do have left. This one over here. Now look, she putting on her glasses.
I might as well.
Oh, might as well.
This I might as well.
What they're made for. To protect your pupils.
Oh, be quiet.
So if I go blind, you gonna take care of me?
Yes, indeed. I already take care of a blind man.
Who?
Thought he was, boy.
Blind man, you take care of. Oh, it's your child.
Yeah, we got a blind client. What y'all think, y'all? What y'all think? I got so many sunglasses and I do not rock them.
Did you just hear that though? Complain about me.
But did you hear what I just say? I do not rock them.
Boosh.
Yeah, they for the sun and they for the daylight and all that. Yeah, I understand
Boosh.
That. And then I got this pair too. Ooh, wait a minute.
You want it bull?
I can't even put them on. I'd like these better, guys. Ooh, come on now.
Oh, I got on a pair.
Which pair y'all like better? The first pair or this pair? I like these better. I like the vision out of them better also. She want me to show y'all her shoes. No, I'll show y'all when she get out the car. And
I forgot I bought these. And I don't even wear them.
She got another pair of shoes in the mail today. So she was like, I should have waited until today to do the video. So we'll just put it in a blog somewhere. In the vlog somewhere, we'll put it in there. Yes, I'm on Weight Watchers, guys, but this is actually my free day. So I was gonna wait until the weekend, but since Dre's home, this, you know, all my days off, I'll make this my free day today. So we'll be back when we figure out what we're gonna eat. Okay, y'all, so we here. Guess what we at, guys? Golden Corral. Dre likes a variety of foods. But she want me to show y'all her shoes. You forgot to show them these or what?
Yep.
Oh.
They already know what they are.
So what are you about to do?
I gotta repark this truck, y'all. I'm parking crooked like Dre. I'm drunk.
She about to, I don't want to put the light, ooh, I put the light splash on. She about to repark the truck because it's a little bit crooked, y'all.
OCD.
That's why I tell you about an OCD ass person. So y'all, guess what? We ain't go to Corral, right? Guess what? We seen one of Dre's exes. And she gave a hug. Well, the girl was like, give me some. Like, you know, like, give me a hug. She gave a hug. So I told her, if I see my ex and I give a hug, don't say nothing. And I didn't snap because she should know better. Because if it was me, I don't get my ex, and I don't give people that much.
If they would ask you.
No, I don't give them that. Come on now. No. I don't give them that much time. You know what I mean? I speak, and I keep it moving, stuff like that. I don't sit there and conversate. I don't do none of that. Matter of fact, we did run into one of my exes. I spoke, and I kept it moving.
Who?
Bay Beach. She said hi, I said hey, and kept it moving.
Did she ask for a hug?
If she would've, I would've, no, it don't. You think I'm finna hug another chick in your face? My ex?
She's not my ex.
She is.
She's not my ex.
It is.
She's not my ex. Why you got that camera on me like that?
Because you got some explaining to do.
So, you put me on camera because?
We gotta tell our family and keep it real.
Y'all don't know the real reason why I did that. The bitch is crazy.
Crap.
You don't tell your head?
With certain people.
No.
People always act a certain way around certain people.
No.
But people know who not to pull it around. People know who not to pull it with. Straight up. She crazy, I'm crazy, everybody got a crazy side. So guys, we decided to come to Golden Corral. And it's cold in here, so I got on my jacket. But here's my food. Dre and her food. And yeah, so we'll be back when we done eating.
What's going on, Life Pack? We got a little issue here. She's mad at me because we came out here to Golden Corral to eat and I ran into one of my exes. I gave her a hug and she is pissed as hell at me. I want to know, do y'all think that I was wrong for hugging her? She don't mean shit to me.
No, don't make it sound like that. Don't make
she
it sound.
She don't.
But don't make it sound like that.
She mad as hell at me.
I'm pissed off.
She's pissed at me because I gave her a hug. And then I apologize, but I want to know from y'all viewers. If you was to see your ex and you was with your mate and you gave them a hug, would it mean anything? Would it mean something? Or is just something, I don't know. Maybe I'm not explaining it right or asking the question right, but yeah, we own here because, like I said, you know, we don't sugarcoat anything. When shit happens between us, you know, We like to get an opinion from others. I told her, you know, I apologize if I made her feel any type of way, but in actuality, in all honesty, it wasn't shit. She don't mean shit to me. And basically, it is what it is.
She making me seem like the bad person, and so y'all can look at her and be like, oh,
no,
yeah,
I'm not.
Okay, so be quiet, you know, when I say my part.
Put up there so they both can see both of our asses.
Okay, so this is what I'm saying about the situation. I felt like I know about this girl. I know about, you know, I know about the past.
Only from what I told you.
Exactly. It doesn't matter. But I'm saying is, it's her, somebody that she used to mess with. And I feel like, out of respect for me, your new woman, and you know I know about this girl, don't, why would you hug her? Like, you basically showed her that she still got it like that. You know what I mean? That's just how females think. Like, yeah, she got a new girl, but I bet you she gave me a hug type thing. You know what I mean? I'm just saying, I'm not jealous or nothing like that, but I just feel like, out of respect, don't fucking hug your ex, especially right in front of me. That's disrespectful. And not only that, if it was me, I would not give my ex the time of day to even hug me. Out of respect, and the respect that I have for Dre, I wouldn't be hugging on my ex. That's what I mean when I say she too fucking friendly. It's a video.
And if you have,
I'm gonna link the video down below. And I'm y'all look at that when I say Dre's too fucking friendly. That's what I'll be talking about.
What video?
When I say you too friendly. You don't freaking hug your ex-girlfriend in front of your new woman. Like, I'm just sorry.
Do y'all feel if I was wrong?
No, not do they feel if you wrong. What do y'all think? Do y'all agree?
Yeah, what do y'all think?
Do y'all think it was okay for her to hug her ex-girlfriend? I could have been real ignorant just now and just hold off on her in there. But I'm like, you know what I'm saying? I'm a grown woman, so I ain't gonna do nothing like that. But just the simple fact, Dre,
baby,
you know better.
Ain't nobody I want.
So what? You know better.
You know that. Stop. Come on. Come on.
Stop, Dre. Cause I gotta get it out of my system. Because you don't fucking love nobody I know about in my goddamn face.
Alright, y'all.
I walked off and stuff, and the girl, I'm pretty sure she know who I am, because one day when me and Dre had first got together, and we was in a shoe store, and I was looking at some shoes, and Dre had seen her in the mall. And the girl came in the, well, we, she came in the store we was at and walked past me to let, like I said, certain people crazy with the right one.
No.
Cause she was like, she crazy. Okay, she crazy. And certain people know who to pull it with.
I didn't want it to be an altercation, okay? That's another reason.
Oh, so she said she hugged her because she didn't want her to say nothing or start nothing with me.
Cause she would have. She just that fucking crazy.
Right. Okay, everybody crazy in their own way. And like I said, certain people, some people know who to pull it with. And she ain't stupid. And like I said, I seen her before. Multiple times. But like I was saying,
the city is too damn small, y'all.
We seen her in the shoe store. Dre didn't tell me that she messed with her and all that until we was out of the shoe store, out of the mall. I was pissed because I felt like you should have told me when we was in the store, because what if she would have tried to haul off and hit me? I don't even know what's going on because she mad.
Of course I would have.
She mad.
Come on now.
No, I'm just saying, you let me know so I know what the hell I'm, you know what I'm saying? Don't
at that time.
Don't keep me on the blind side like that.
Let me explain to you why I did that. At that time, I ended it with her on bad terms, and the conversation between her and I, which I had with her, that was like probably 1 or 2 years after that. I didn't know what type of bag she was gonna come out of. So when she walked in the store, she was over there trying on shoes and stuff. I was watching her. And I didn't say nothing because she's a hot box. Why she wanna sit there and act like she's so sweet, innocent?
Who? I wouldn't have been ignorant like that.
If provoked, because the bitch would have provoked you. I'm trying to tell you.
But then she
would have
been pulling it with the right one. Some people.
Why let you get in some type of shit like that?
Girl, bye.
the next thing and the best thing for you to do is walk the fuck away. You don't hug no other woman around me like that. That's disrespectful. All right. Like I said, if it was my ex and I hugged my ex, come on in this camera while you dipping out. If it was me and my ex, and you know about my ex, and you know I was creeping with my ex, not on the cheating level, just because I wasn't ready to be like known yet.
Hold up. So that was your ex?
No, I'm saying.
She wasn't.
Come on, Dre. Don't try to do that. No, I'm serious.
No. See, this was.
She wasn't my ex, but I'm saying to Dre, she was my ex because Dre said if she. Too much. Dre said if we got down, she don't care what that mean. That, you know what I'm saying?
That was her girl undercover, okay?
That was not my girl.
Then I found out that I wasn't her first, so that was, you know.
Okay, so anyway, let me tell y'all.
So I went to the left.
Like I said, if it was me and my ex, and I seen my ex-girl, and I hugged her, how would you feel about the situation? And she never still answered my question. You know what she said? She don't know.
You know what, to be honest with you? And I know, see, the chick she was messing around with, she didn't want to give her the time of day, but she was still fucking with her. And when she told her she didn't want to be in a relationship, the girl, I don't know, she lost it, moved out of town, all kind of shit, I don't know. So when she found out that she got with me, a female, so she like, wait a minute, what the fuck she got that I don't have? So
okay, same thing with you.
And I never did.
Exactly.
So
she
evidently,
she popped back up on the scene, and then let me make the bad part about it, y'all. She didn't. It wasn't those kind of speaks where you be like, "Hey, how you doing?" It wasn't like that. It was, "Hey, how you doing? Give me some. Give me some loving. Give me some." She hugged him.
It wasn't shit.
She hugged him.
It wasn't shit.
Dre, shut up. I don't care.
You know what?
If it wasn't nothing.
It wasn't shit, y'all. And it then, wasn't shit.
And then the girl saying, "I thought you moved. I thought you moved." So therefore, you've been looking for. Like I told Dre, me being a woman and I know women, she about to be trying to find Dre on Facebook. She finna be trying to find her some type of way. Cause mind you, that's what kind of relationship they had.
You know what? Only thing you know
is what,
I told you.
Am I lying?
But that's my past though.
But I don't give a shit.
You know what? I said my piece. I've apologized to her. So I don't know what more she want me to say to her. But
y'all,
you know,
don't let Dre make y'all think she's innocent about this situation.
I'm not sitting up here.
I said I apologize. And I don't know what she want me to do.
So don't do that.
That's what you just said.
No the fuck I did.
Yes you did.
No the fuck I did.
Yo. I'm about to go, cause
at the end of the day, who am I with? At the end of the motherfucking day, who am I with?
Yourself.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Okay. Be careful what you say now.
Be careful what the fuck you say.
All right.
No, matter of fact, be careful what you do.
All right. Not really feeling dry.
I ain't got my seatbelt on.
Yeah, I guess you better strap the fuck up.
Anyway, y'all, so we're about to go home and turn that light on.
They see you good.
No, turn that light. That don't do that. I don't want no ugly dark channel. I mean videos. So we're about to go home and probably attempt to do these videos that I was planning on doing today. Trey, shut up. So anyway, y'all, I'm coming back on here to let y'all know that I was just telling her what she should have did is when the girl was like, "Hey, blah blah blah, give me a hug, or give me some." That's what she said. Give me some. When she said that, what Dre should have said is, correct me if I'm wrong. What Dre should have said was, "No, out of respect, I can't do that. I'm not, and I'm with my girl. But you know, it was nice seeing you. Whatever the case may be, you know." Cause I'm a very friendly person. Very friendly. Not friendly as in flirting and touchy, but I'm very friendly.
you know, person. But I know where to draw the line at, and I know when to be talkative, and I know when not to give you that much conversation. You know what I mean? And when I say Dre is too friendly, it's because she don't know when to give or to cut off her conversation. And when I said the girl, when the girl was like, give me a hug, well, give me some love and the love, or give me something, whatever she said, Dre should have been like, nah, I can't do that right now out of respect because I want my girl, but, you know, see you later, and it was nice seeing you. Now, what do y'all think? She could have went another route. Her giving that girl a hug was the thing to do. Or do y'all think I'm tripping? I'm not tripping because I'm very, very friendly and talkative and all that, like I say. And Dre can vouch for me right now. I don't care who she talked to. I don't care who she conversate with. Matter of fact, I am the one, the reason why Dre talks and sociable like she is, and tell her to stop acting antisocial, sociable, and you know what I'm saying? Right or wrong? Huh?
You really want me to answer that?
So you saying I have a problem when you conversate with people?
I had a friend, y'all, a coworker. She swore up and down this woman wanted me. She was an older woman.
She did like Dre. Fuck are you talking about? She used to take Dre on dinner, lunch.
It was no. It was.
She used to. No.
Strictly
no.
Plutonic.
What the frick ever look?
It's strictly plutonic.
Ploop my ass. Wow. She used to treat Dre to lunch. Right?
So friends can't treat people to lunch?
Okay. I ain't. Only when I'm at work. But when I'm at home.
That's bullshit.
She ain't treating nobody to
That's
lunch.
That's bullshit. She came up to, we had a barbecue, and we invited her over to the
like
house.
Like I said, I was at work when they went on the lunch date. I didn't even trip. I just was like, oh, okay, you know. And then when she started trying to take on lunch dates more and more, I'm like, what, back the fuck up. And if it was me.
Where's Tina at?
Dre would be in her chest while
Tell
she trying to act like.
His ass outside right now to bring his
while she trying to act like, ain't now. nothing. You know what I'm saying? It's all good though. Just tell me, comment down below what y'all think. Would you turn that goddamn heat off? I'm finna pass out. I'm just saying, don't be hugging no motherfucking body around me. Cause I wouldn't do it to you. So respect me. And they are only.
And now you want.
This is like real money. It's alright.